Selamat datang ke sesi pembentangan selari, sesi petang di Bilik Zamrud. Petang kita ada dua pembentangan kertas kajian, iaitu kertas kajian 14 dan kertas kajian 15. Ya. Pembentang bagi kertas kajian 14 ialah Puan Zeti Amy binti Muhammad Kamri dari SK Seri Indrapolis, dan tajuk pembentangannya ialah Digital Education Through Research in Digital Teaching and Learning, the Purpose of Using Google Classroom from the Perspective of Primary School Teachers. Manakala pembentangan kertas kajian yang kedua, iaitu kajian 15 oleh Puan Rosita binti Paiman, SK Sungai Lesung, Kampar Perak, tajuk kertas kajian Pendekatan Latih Tubi Berasaskan Teknologi dan Petak Zia Tato Membantu Meningkatkan Penguasaan Menambah Dua Nombor Dengan Mengumpul Semula bagi Pelajar Tahun 3. Sedikit panduan kepada para pembentang. Tempoh masa yang diperuntukkan untuk pembentangan ialah keseluruhannya 20 minit, 15 minit pembentangan dan 5 minit untuk sesi soal jawab. Lonceng kali pertama akan dibunyikan bagi 10 minit pertama. Boleh kita bunyikan lonceng? Bagi tadi kita tak bunyikan ya. Okay, itu yang kali yang pertama. Lonceng kedua dibunyikan 2 kali, menandakan pembentangan mempunyai 5 minit ya, betul? Untuk menamatkan pembentangan. Okay, lonceng kali ketiga, iaitu 1 kali, akan dibunyikan sekali, menandakan sesi soal jawab telah tamat ya. Okay, kerjasama setiap peserta di dalam Bilik Zamrud ini dimohon untuk meminimumkan pergerakan dalam bilik pembentangan bagi menghormati pembentang yang membuat pembentangan ya. Saya juga ingin ingatkan bagi mereka yang belum scan QR code ya, untuk scan QR code bagi mengesahkan kehadirannya di Bilik Zamrud ini. Okay, seterusnya, dengan tanpa melengahkan masa, saya jemput Puan Zeti Amy binti Muhammad Kamri dari SK Sri Indrapolis untuk membuat pembentangan. Dipersilakan.
Assalamualaikum and a very good afternoon to all my fellow friends here. I'm Madam Zeti Amy binti Muhammad Kamri. Previously, I'm from SK Seri Indra, and I am an English teacher, but now I'm working in IPG. Okay, this is my action research before I got my promoted to the IPG. Okay, let us look at the title, Digital Education Through Research in Digital Teaching and Learning, the Purpose of Using Google Classroom from the Perspective of School Students. It's not school teachers, it's school students. Okay. Okay, first let me introduce you. We're all familiar with the word Google Classroom, right? Actually, Google Classroom is a free web platform that developed by Google. We have it has been introduced to us in year 2014, and it's a teaching medium that essential for both teachers and students. So this is one of the option that we can use when it comes to the methods of teaching and learning. Okay, in Malaysia as well, educators and students are embracing materializing technologies to enhance their professional and academic performance. As we know, in digital era, we need to use the digital platform to capture or to motivate our students. But in this study, I want to know the perception of the students. Nowadays, we are always ask about the teachers how you feel teaching using the AI and so on. But in this case, we want to know what is the student feel and how they perceive the Google Classroom. Okay, English teachers have incorporated these technologies into their teaching practices, revolutionizing English instruction through the use of advanced tools. Booba, Pixar, Ms. Jason, all they have their own research on this Google Classroom. So basically, this is a quite long quote. Mahathir emphasized that technology makes teaching more engaging and effective. As what we know, our objective is the understanding or the impact of our student, how we comprehend our lesson and make our student understand how we want to make the session meaningful. That's the most important thing, is how the student, how did our lesson give the impact for them. Okay, this platform facilitates seamless collaborations, init collaborations, enables teachers to monitor student progress. As we know, using Google Classroom, we can monitor the student from the assignment, the homework, and also we can use this platform as a hybrid, like we did in our hall today. Hybrid, meaning that if your student absent from that day, so you can post your slide or your link or your material in the Google Classroom, so she or he will be not left out. Okay, this way. Okay, this study focuses on how Google Classroom utilized for English language learning and develops into student perspective and experiences with the platform itself. Okay. Okay, this is the literature review, LR. User-friendly design. Google Classroom is designed to be user-friendly, so it's very easy for us to use the Google Classroom. But it might be quite hard for the, what we said previously, or the old teachers, but once you go into deep and you learn how to use Google Classroom, you will thank to the Google for developing this Google Classroom. Okay, help teachers and students stay organized with their coursework. It's a very organized LMS system. If you have a Google Classroom, you can ask your student to do work there. You can assign their homework, you can assign their project, and it can be seen by their parent as well. So it will be there. The evidence is there. That's what we know. That's what we want. Because nowadays, if we want to evaluate using the PBD, so the most important thing is the evidence. So we have the evidence there in the Google Classroom itself. Okay, it allows the establishment of virtual classroom environment, saving time, money, and physical space. We also can do example. This is, I'm giving the example. Maybe I have a courses, so I might leave the school for 2 or 3 days. So that using Google Classroom, we can do extra classes during our own space, maybe at night. And the student, especially the parents, they are very happy to have the GM session with the teacher. It's not the parent lah, students. Okay? Efficiency and time management. Enable teacher to dedicate more time to student and less to administrative tasks. So in Google Classroom, as you can see, we can link it to the Lima as well. In the Lima, as we can explore, there are so many apps, AI apps. Nowadays, if you want to prepare slide, for example, you have so many work to do at school or you have courses. So if you want to prepare slide, you don't have ample time to prepare the slide. So you have, there is AI tools, Conquer, the Gamma AI. Even within 2 seconds, you can provide 14 slides. So there is no reason, or there is no burden at all. You have to work smart. Okay. positive feedback on promoting blended learning. As we know, Google Classroom also itself is a blended learning platform with technology despite some challenges. Okay, it enhanced communication, seamless instructional interface, and assignment management. Efficient communication through announcement, email, and push notification. We know, we can access our students. We know who has submitted their work, who have not, and we can monitor from any place, any time. Okay, preparation for future career. Using this classroom also, educational leader exercise equipping students with the skills they know how to use. Even though the student didn't know how to operate the Canva, the AI, modern technology for post-graduation and global competitiveness. So it will be easier for them when they go to the secondary school, to the university, they have been exposed. As you know, in IPG also we have Google Classroom for the student itself. So it might be easier for them because they have the basics. Okay, parents, teachers and students request technology integration to prepare for future career and enhance engagement. Sorry. Advantages of learning management system. This is what we call learning management system. Example for the school. We use Google Classroom app. You can add in your EIPH as well. So that you give the link so we can see the evidence of our student if you want to give the marks to bench like TP1 to TP2, TP3. Okay. Let me see what is the advantages of management system. It enable interactive communication, same, enhancing engagement, understanding, support high retention rate through self-paced learning with internet access. Students can learn anywhere. Even while waiting for their parent, if they have the gadget or smartphone, they can access assignment or homework. Okay, teacher gives the homework, so I have to finish it within this period. While waiting on my father, I can complete my work. Flexible learning during and after formal classes. Okay, challenges and adoption. This is what Town and Town 2011, they done their study and they found that in their pilot test they have 4 schools that did not use the LMS at all. What happened? This is supposed to be a very good and interactive platform to the teachers and students, but they don't even log in. Okay, Google Classroom encourage active learning and enables teachers to create student-centered, collaborative, and memorable lesson. While doing this actual research, I noticed the finding that not even we know the perception of student, but I also discovered a new issues that we can discover a new issue from Google Classroom where during the pandemic, all the students enhanced their speaking skill has been enhanced to the one level. Do you believe it or not? Because using a Google Classroom, they feel more confident to speak, they feel more motivated to use Google Classroom. Almost all of the students can speak and use the Google Classroom very well. So instead of the interactive platform, and it also cater the need of the students. Okay, the objective of Mastery is the research aim to comprehend the purpose of Google Classroom as a learning tool. I want all the teachers to use the Google Classroom because it is a very effective way to explore how primary school students perceive Google Classroom as a teaching tool and its impact on their learning experience. Actually, the first step is the hardest. When we get to use it, it will be easier for us to use either teachers or the student. Okay, my research methodology is qualitative. study utilizing semi-structured questionnaire and interview conducted in that school. Okay, the data analysis, I'm using Creswell X, their approach for qualitative data analysis. And the participant respondent, in year 4 students comprising 2 girls and 2 boys were from one of the primary schools located in the state of Perlis. Okay, this girl is, the participant are from the DMP classes. So the interview, the recorded version, the record interview are conducted in English. Okay, the result and discussion. The Google Classroom is perceived as interactive, effective, up-to-date, and conducive for students as they complete their academic tasks, whether it's a coursework or homework. It provides effortless access to material, assignment, and discussion from various devices, meaning that they can use PC, they can use tablet, they can use laptop anywhere, even while they have it, COCO in their school, they still can have Google Classroom, what we call hybrid. We have the hybrid session when we do COCO and for our assembly. Okay? It can boost confidence and willingness to explore language skills. This is what I discovered, speaking skill. It enhances speaking skill. Enhance interaction with teacher and peers. Reduce dependence on physical resources. Immediate update and changes to content and design. You don't need, teachers, you don't need to prepare the materials, the teaching aids, the actual teaching aid. But you can use the virtual one. You can use AR. Because we want to capture their interest. They love, student kids, they love AI so much. Even if we teach them how to use, they can come up with a very attractive slide. They come up with very video, 2 minutes presentation. Even year 4, year 3, year 5, even year 1, they can come up, produce that such a very beautiful arrangement of video. Okay, let's also provide timely feedback. Assess it for any. Okay, any place, but anywhere. Venue for it, paperless format. Google Classroom is efficient and environmentally friendly. No need to use sources like paper. No paper. No need to write. Now, this student is very lazy to write. Right? You just want to click or scroll. Did you notice something that their penmanship, why they always write G from the below to up? Why? That one, I also did research about that. How? Why? Why almost a dependency? They like to write from the bottom to up because of they use to scroll. They scroll a lot, they screen time. So it affects the psychomotor, which they cannot write very well. That's the case. Okay? It increases students' interest and motivation. Facilitate communication and create engaging classroom environment. They engage very well. Enhancing student involvement and providing fast and easy feedback can enhance the learning experience. That's what we want. Meaningful learning experience. If we teacher, we don't expose these tools, they don't even experience anything, right? Okay, these are the respondent response. The participant respond with, they say that Google Classroom modern, engaging layout with 3D and 4D visual elements. They like it so much. Perceived as interactive, effective, up to date. Visual appealing content layout with colorful, eye-catching design. They also like the interactive quizzes and assignment to boost their enthusiasm. Preferred over traditional. Yeah, this is all. They always say like that. We love using Google Classroom instead of using a textbook. Even though, but it actually, yeah, textbook. But it has been put off design. We take the textbook and then we do the there is a textbook and we flip in our dilemma, right? You can just take the link and put in our Google Classroom. It will be easier. But more or less, it's the same, but in a different terms and different platform. Okay, offer a modern learning style suitable for the 21st century. Effective time management by completing tasks while waiting for the parent. This answer, almost all of them answer, they answer this. They say, while waiting for their parents instead of Google or scrolling for TikTok, they do their work because they say, we want to sleep early at night. We don't have time. We don't want to write at night. So, we can do it while waiting for our parent. It depends to the school. Some school, they provide like a space for the student while waiting with, they provide the laptop as well. So you can, the student can access the laptop while waiting. Okay? User friendly with simple click and type tasks, increase student interest and motivation. Okay, the conclusion is effective learning platform. Google Classroom is very effective learning platform. So teachers, it emerged as an effective learning platform that enhanced student engagement, motivation, and overall learning experiences in English. This is what we want. We don't want students to afraid of English lesson. Why? Because they feel scared of speaking, they feel scared of writing, so they don't want to learn English. But actually, they said, wow, English is fine, it's really easy. Don't give too much input. You just make them learning without they realizing, indirectly learned, okay? Positive student experience, same, interactive, fun, efficient learning tools, positively impacting their perception of learning. Okay, a valuable alternative to traditional English learning. We want them to change their thought, their perception about learning English from boring to fun, from scared to they're willing, they're eager to learn. Foster a positive attitude and engagement, encourage further exploration of Google Classroom for modern English education. Okay, meaning that what I discovered that using Google Classroom, it can create a sense of responsibility when we assign a student as a class monitor, he or she will every day she will look at the posted material or from the teacher. So he will or she will tell their friends that okay, we have assignment today or work today. So let us do the work. Okay. The conclusion. Instead of having a Google Classroom as a platform in teaching English, some of the teachers also scared of using Google Classroom. They said they don't know. That's why I said the first step is the hardest. Once you have learned, you will fall in love with the Google Classroom. Because you can insert, you can assign anywhere. Now it collapsed with the Canva, you can assign the work from the Canva to your Google Classroom as well. So many features there.
Okay. So, 15 minit masa pembentangan telah tamat.
Okay, thank you.
Jadi kita buka untuk sesi soal jawab. Ya. Kalau ada sebarang pertanyaan, boleh dikemukakan dalam bahasa Melayu dan juga dalam bahasa Inggeris. Ya. So saya persilakan kalau ada rakan yang ingin mengemukakan soalan. Okay. Tidak, nanti saya akan tanya Dr. Faizal untuk kemukakan. So, ada pertanyaan yang ingin dikemukakan? Kalau tak ada, saya mulakan dulu ya. So, what's the biggest challenge in implementing this research?
Okay, the biggest challenge is implementing this Google Classroom is we as a teacher ourselves. We don't have effort to learn, we don't have time to implement it to our student. That is not our fault at all. We as a teacher and also also the administration, you have to provide everything. If we can, we don't have don't have the internet Wi-Fi, you can download it for those in Sarawak and in Sabah. But here, that's what I say. As a teacher, you have to give your full effort, use, and you have to teach them from the beginning, from year one. I have taught my year one until I follow my student from year one till year five. And what I did is from year one, I expose to them how to use Google Classroom, how to present in front of the class, how to manage, how to use the mind map and so on. So, but suitable for their level. If you want to present maybe a paragraph or two or three sentences. After that, you uploaded the presentation or you can record it, the presentation, and you upload it in your social media or your TikTok. Or I always upload it in my Google Classroom so that the parent as well can see the what their kids do in the school. So it is a motivation. So we have a smart TV in our school. So once time we let the student to watch the video, we take it from the Google and we put it in the smart TV so that the whole school watch the video. So what do you think they feel? We have to, the teacher itself and of course the administration, we have to encourage your teachers.
Ada soalan lain yang ingin dikemukakan?
Yes.
Persilakan kat belakang sana tu, Dr. I forgot your name. This morning you presented, pagi tadi ada buat pembentangan, Dr. Rainer Beng Tang Kui, right? Yes. Dipersilakan.
Good afternoon, everyone. First of all, congratulations for your presentation. I have only two questions. One is, how long did you carry out this research? And then number two, you showed that in your discussion, you mentioned that Google Classroom is effective.
Yeah.
And how do you measure the effectiveness? Because from what I saw, you only mentioned that your instruments were semi-structured interviews, and it didn't say anything. I mean, it doesn't show over there any pre or post test. Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you, Doctor. Okay, for the first question, I have been carrying out the research for almost 1.5 years. Actually, it has a few notes and some of the instrument, but I summarize it in a very short article. So it left out. So the instrument are for only the questionnaire, but I also have the what we call a GF form, and we also do for qualitative interview and the evaluation, how I know the effectiveness of this Google Classroom. From the assessment itself, assessment meaning that it's not assess how the student use, but their result in the speaking, their result in the writing, reading. Why I say that? Because before they get to use to the Google Classroom, some of them, they don't even want to write. They don't even want to do homework. But when I use the Google Classroom, even though for quizzes or Kahoot, just like simple quizzes, like what, but once practice makes perfect, right? They use it, and when it comes to the assessment, we can see the increasing of the mark, the bench, how it increased. For the first time, I wonder why it has a sudden increase. So, as I said just now, sudden increase for, actually, it comes later, speaking, for the speaking part. I noticed that even though I'm trying to search or study about their perspective, but I noticed one, the increasing of speaking. They feel very motivated and self-confident. The few months before, when I asked them to present, okay, when you wish to present? This is year three. Where you want to present? Here, you can present at your place or in front. okay, at my place. And then for the third lesson, where you want to present? I want to present in front of class. Why? Because through the Google Meet itself, when we ask them to speak, for the first time, they weren't on the camera, for sure. Because they feel very shy. Second time, they put the emoji and so on. The third time, okay, this is me. Because they feel very confident. The no one, this, they say no one. So, no one is watching, so they feel comfortable. That is what we want student to try to use, and then you know how. So, from all the finding, and I come up with another research on psychological aspect that enhancing a student to speak using the digital air, digital AI, or digital tools in for primary school students. And I'm still in process of settling the thesis. Pray for me, I'm now in the chapter 4, I'm collecting data, and now I'm sure that someday it will benefit at least, maybe not all, maybe some of the students from, especially from the rural area.
Okay, terima kasih Puan Zanti Imi, binti Muhammad Kamri, right? Kamri, sebelum ini berada di SK Sri Indra Perlis dan kini bertugas di IPG. IPG mana tu?
IPG Perlis.
IPG Perlis, okey. Terima kasih ya atas pembentangan kajian itu. Seterusnya saya jemput round of applause. Ya. Okay, seterusnya saya jemput Puan Rosita binti Paiman dari SK Sungai Lesung. Bukan Losong ya. SK Sungai Lesung, Kampar Perak untuk pembentangan kajian bertajuk Pendekatan Latih Tubi Berasaskan Teknologi dan Beta Zitato Membantu Meningkatkan Penguasaan Menambah 2 Nombor dengan mengumpul semula bagi pelajar tahun 3. Dipersilakan.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh dan selamat petang. Yang dihormati juri-juri dan juga rakan-rakan guru sekalian. Saya Cikgu Rosita Binti Paiman daripada SK Sungai Lesung, Perak. Saya akan bentangkan okay, saya akan bentangkan kajian tindakan saya bertajuk Pendekatan Latih Tubi Berasaskan Teknologi dan adalah merupakan operasi pertama yang dibukakan pada murid-murid.
Maknanya murid-murid perlu menguasai operasi tambahan. Sebelum lebih lanjut lagi, dia perlu menguasai yang lain. Okey, oleh itu, sebagai guru, kita disarankan supaya menggunakan kreativiti dan persoalan kita untuk tahap kualiti kanak-kanak dalam melaksanakan pengajaran dan pembelajaran supaya lebih berkesan. Okey, oleh itu, kita sebagai guru, kita mesti ada cara. Bagaimana kita nak menyelesaikan masalah, bagaimana kita nak mengajar anak murid kita. Okey, dengan itu, dalam hari ini, saya penggunaan teknologi yang bersesuaian juga boleh membantu meningkatkan pencapaian murid. Okay. Dalam hari ini, di murid ini kita lihat sama begitu keliru dalam hidup dia nak menyelesaikan masalah tambah pula. Okey. Dan fokus kajian saya ialah meningkatkan kemahiran menggambar berumur dengan mengukus. Okey, berteraskan pada teori Jean Piaget.
Okey, berteraskan pada teori Jean Piaget, iaitu Jean Piaget, murid-murid ni, murid-murid umur anak murid saya ni dalam darjah 3 memerlukan objek-objek dan prinsip konkret sebelum dapat menyelesaikan masalah. Dalam hal ini, saya menggunakan petak Zitato dan juga latih tubi berasaskan teknologi. Petak Zitato ni digunakan khas untuk dia menambah dan menolak. Tapi untuk kajian ini saya gunakan untuk menolak. Dan saya gabungkan dia dengan latih tubi berasaskan teknologi. Okay. Objektif dan persoalan kajian. Objektif saya meningkatkan kemahiran murid menambah dua nombor dengan nombor semula melalui gabungan pendekatan latih tubi dan berasaskan teknologi dan penggunaan petak Zitato. Yang kedua, mengaplikasi pendekatan latih tubi berasaskan teknologi dan penggunaan petak Zitato dalam menyelesaikan penambahan dua nombor. Dan persoalan kajian, apa yang nak saya cari ialah adakah gabungan pendekatan latih tubi berasaskan teknologi ini dan penggunaan petak Zitato dapat meningkatkan kemahiran murid menambah dua nombor dengan mengumpul semula. Seterusnya, apakah aplikasi penggunaan ini dapat membantu murid untuk menyelesaikan soalan? Okey, tenihan. Okey, metodologi kajian saya adalah mengikut pada model Kurt Lewin 1946. Saya menggunakan ini sebab dia dilihat lebih mudah untuk dijalankan. Dia mempunyai 4 peringkat iaitu merancang, bertindak, memerhati dan mereflek. Iaitu satu kitaran kajian. Pada awalnya saya merancang, iaitu mengumpul data dari murid-murid tahun 3 kelas saya. Lepas tu mengenal pasti kumpulan sasaran, merangka pelan tindakan berdasarkan model kajian saya, dan seterusnya merancang membina bahan tindakan. Seterusnya saya pergi pada bertindak, dan bertindak saya melaksanakan proses PDP dengan menggunakan bahan tindakan tadi, dan seterusnya saya pada pemerhatian, memerhati peserta kajian sepanjang saya menjalankan kaedah itu. Saya gunakan bahan tadi, lepas tu dan akhir sekali berrefleks. Refleks kenal pasti kekuatan dan kelemahan, jalan yang pernah perbaikan. Okay, seterusnya dalam pergi pada perancangan, saya telah mengenal pasti kumpulan sasaran ini. Pertama sekali saya lihat pada sembahkan buku tulis murid. Lepas tu semasa pengajaran, adakah murid saya ini menghadapi masalah dalam menambah dan seterusnya. Okey, ujian sebelum, dan saya telah jalankan ujian intervensi terhadap murid saya. Semua ada 20 orang saya jalankan, dan saya dapat kenal pasti ada 6 orang ini bermasalah dan sangat bermasalah dalam pengajaran penambahan. Okey, kemudian saya telah jalankan soal sendiri. Soal sendiri saya jalankan bukanlah soalan sijil yang ni, saya jalankan soal sijil tidak formal. Saya tanya kenapa dan bagaimana, apakah berlaku. Dan kebanyakan mereka menyatakan mereka tak suka matematik sebab dia susah. Nombor dia besar. Kalau besar, kami tak nak belajar matematik. Okey, itu isunya. Seterusnya saya menggalakkan jenakan. Kumpulan sasaran saya ialah 6 orang murid. 3 lelaki dan 3 perempuan. Ini bukan saya ambil terus ambil 3, saya nak 3-3. Tak, saya telah jalankan soal ujian sebelum intervensi. Okey. Bahan yang saya gunakan ialah, pertama sekali saya gunakan penggunaan bahan latihan berasaskan teknologi ini, saya telah gunakan word wall. Okey, word wall latihan. Saya telah masukkan dalam Google Classroom dan murid menjawab. Okey, menjawab di dalam kelas. Okey, sekolah saya telah diberikan laptop dan saya telah bawa laptop itu ke dalam kelas untuk murid menjawab. Okey, dan seterusnya kami menggunakan penggunaan petak zita tu. Cikgu jangan salah ni, nanti saya akan jelaskan bila masa guna petak zita tu, bila masa guna ni. Okey, penggunaan petak zita tu ni, ini adalah petak zita tu. Zita tu. Z dari pengkaji, ta tolak, tu tambah. Okey. Contohnya, saya bagi soalan 5 tambah 8. Dan dia dah tunjuk 5 dan dia bergerak 8 kali dan dapat jawapan dia 13. Okey. Seterusnya, tindakan dan pemerhatian. Okey. Intervensi pertama yang saya jalankan ialah aktiviti pertama, murid didedahkan cara menggunakan petak zita tu. Petak zita tu saya derahkan dulu. Sebab murid ni bila dia tak terus saja kita menggunakan bahan teknologi, dia akan terkejut. Jadi saya gunakan dulu bahan yang menggunakan petak zita tu. Okey. Murid didedahkan cara menampak dan dia akan buat soalan. Dia jalankan soalan. Intervensi kedua, aktiviti kedua, murid didedahkan dengan latih tubi dan soalan dengan juga perisan word wall tu dan juga petak zita tu. Maknanya dia menjawab soalan dan berpandukan petak zita tu tu. Dia gerak. Tetapi intervensi ketiga, murid menjawab soalan dalam word wall tu tanpa bantuan petak zita tu. Jadi dia akan bergerak satu-satu saja. Sebab barulah murid dapat memahami konsep penambahan tu. Okey, kita bila kita terus kepada wall tu, mungkin dia teragak-agak macam mana dia nak menambah. Okey. Seterusnya, ini adalah dapatan daripada kajian saya. Okey. Saya telah menjalankan 3 intervensi tadi. Setiap intervensi tu murid akan menjawab soalan. Murid akan menjawab soalan saya berikan. Soalan secara bertulis. Saya tak ambil daripada yang dibuat uang. Sebab saya nak tengok. Bolehkah dia buat? Okey. Jadi sekarang, ada 6 orang ni. Pada langkah pertama penggunaan petak zita tu, dia tak berjaya lagi. Mungkin belum dapat memahami konsep tambah dalam ingatan dia. Sebab lepas tu, yang kedua, semua boleh menjawab dengan baik. Dan kali yang ketiga, semua juga boleh dapat menjawab dengan baik. Dan terjawablah saya punya persoalan, persoalan kajian saya yang pertama tadi. Dan seterusnya, saya buat dapatan temu bual dengan murid tersebut. Murid-murid itu menyatakan, saya tanya, seronok tak belajar dengan cikgu? Suka. Sukalah belajar dengan komputer. Lelaki belajar apa? Dia sebutlah petak zita tu. Dia seronok. Dia seronok. Sebab dua-dua benda tu dia boleh pegang. Dia boleh rasa. Dia bukan gambaran. Kita perlu paksa dia untuk hafal. Contoh, 7 tambah 8. Kalau dengan jari dia terkejar sebab tak cukup jari dia. Murid dah ajar 3, memang saya dah ajar, dia dah ajar 1, guna jari tambah. Tapi, murid ni dia akan rasa terbeban. Dia selalu rasa terbeban sebab dia tak cukup terbeban. Dia nak benda senang. Dia kalau boleh, senang meniru. Dia nak meniru saya. Tapi sekarang saya sediakan supaya dia boleh explore diri dia. Okay, kita tak paksa dia. Dia tengok, dia suka banget. Okay, selepas tu saya jalankan juga ujian intervensi selepas. Maknanya dari ujian yang pertama, ujian kedua, alhamdulillah, 5 dari murid saya tu dapat jawab dengan betul semua soalan. Tapi seorang tu dia ada kecuaian sikit. Satu soalan di sana. Okey? Dari rumusan ini dapatlah tengok daripada kajian saya. Ini adalah gambar ni seorang murid ni terang menjawab kan. Cikgu dia nak expose diri jugalah dia dalam ni. Okey. Lepas tu ni penambah baik amalan pengajian pengajaran guru. Okey. Saya rasa bila saya dah guna word wall ni, wah, budak ni suka belajar. Tak adalah kalau dalam kelas macam nak tidur, ngantuk je kan. Ha, cikgu matematik ni selalu garang, dia tak berani nak tidur. Tapi kita nampak muka dia dah tahan aja, sabar. Nah, tapi sejak saya gunakan word wall ni, saya gunakan titubi ni, murid, cikgu, hari ni kita belajar komputer lagi tak? Itu je lah. Tapi dia dah makin seronok lah. Kenapa? Bukan lagi paksaan untuk dia belajar. Okay? Kedua, mampu wujudkan aktiviti pembelajaran menyeronokkan. Ini saya tak mahu menyeronokkan. Seronok dia nak belajar. Kalau cikgu matematik datang, dia tak ada lah. Dia takut dia. Cikgu dia buat komputer lah. Kalau buat komputer, mesti kena belajar. Jadi dia seronok. Okey, seterusnya mempertingkatkan penguasaan murid dalam penambahan. Secara tak langsung, murid-murid saya yang ada masalah dalam penambahan dapat menambah dengan baik. Dan pengkaji dapat menilai, menghurai dan menyukakan dengan meneruskan aspek berkaitan permasalahan pengajaran dan pembelajaran. Dalam kajian ini saya dapat huraikan apalah masalah anak murid saya ini. Kenapalah daripada darjah 1 sampai darjah 3 tak boleh-boleh tak. Kenapalah kita sering marahkan dia? Kita sering kata, kenapalah awak ni tak pandai-pandai? Mungkin dia nak satu cara lagi. Kitalah gurunya. Kitalah yang kena buat. Dia takkan buat. Jadi, bila dah seronok dia belajar, insya-Allah seterusnya dia akan dapat apa ilmu yang kita ajar kepada dia. Okey, itu saja. Sekian, terima kasih.
Terima kasih kepada Tuan Rosita Binti Panman dari SK Sungai Lesung, tempat berat atas pembentangan tadi. Jadi saya buka untuk sebarang pertanyaan ataupun soalan yang ingin dibukakan untuk sesi soal jawab. Adakah? Kalau tak ada, saya mulakan dulu ya. Saya ini suka memulakan to get the ball rolling ya. Kajian yang dibuat ini adalah menggunakan petak Zitato. Petak Zitato itu adalah berbantukan komputer. So dalam konteks paper and pencil ni ujian, bagaimana murid akan menyelesaikan sesuatu tugasan lah yang melibatkan dari segi operasi tambah. Sedangkan yang mereka jalani, ya, mereka diuji melalui kajian ini adalah menggunakan petak Zitato. So tanpa komputer, bagaimanakah murid dapat melaksanakan operasi tambah berikut dengan menggunakan paper and pencil?
Okay, terima kasih moderator. Sebenarnya petak Zitato tu pemahaman awal. Mereka macam mana mereka nak menambah. Okay, pemahaman awal macam mana mereka nak menambah. Kalau 5 tambah 8 tadi, dia akan gerakkan, dia akan tahu 13. Okay. Kemudian, saya berikan pula latihan dalam bahan latih tubi. Mereka mula belajar mengingat 5 tambah 8. Tadi dia belajar konsep penambahan, makin lama makin besar. Murid-murid kadang-kadang dia bila menambah, dia tak guna nombor tak ke depan. Sebab kalau dia guna jari yang tak cukup, dia akan nombor dia makin kecil. Dia belajar konsep penambahan, nombor makin lama makin besar. Kemudian, bila saya gunakan bahan latih tubi, mereka akan belajar mengingat. Latihan-latihan yang diberi itu, dia mengingat. Okey. Seterusnya, dengan ingatan itu tadi, dia akan menjawab soalan di dalam atas kertas. Contoh 5 tambah 8 kita tahu berapa. Tapi tanpa penekanan, tanpa kita paksa dia, dia menghafal. Okey? Dia rasa seronok sebab banyak latihan ni, pelbagai latihan yang diberi dalam UON ni, dia akan tengok, dia akan buat berkali-kali, dia akan buat berkali-kali. Jadi dia lama-lama dia dapat 5 tambah 8 tu. Diberi peluang untuk dia mengingat secara tak langsung, dia boleh mengingat.
Ada soalan daripada
baru dia boleh on ya. Okay. Ada soalan yang ingin dikemukakan oleh para peserta. Dr. Faizal, ada soalan yang nak dikemukakan?
Cikgu, saya nak tanya, adakah pentas Zidato ni sesuai untuk yang awal macam tahun 1, tahun 2, itu satu. Dan yang kedua, gunakan word wall ni, cikgu create sendiri ke ataupun memang yang dah ada di
okay, saya ada yang saya create sendiri, ada yang saya ambil sekali untuk submit semua sekali lah, supaya dia banyakkan lagi latihan. Sebab uang ni dia dah letakkan bayaran sekarang. Dia dah letakkan bayaran. Kalau yang percuma kita dapat 4 je. Kita boleh 4. Jadi kita kena bayar. Tapi bayar tu unlimited lah. Tapi dapat sebulan lah. Jadi saya create, saya ada yang saya create, ada yang saya ambil yang dari luar. Masih boleh digunakan. Tapi sebab untuk latihan murid, murid akan buat selalulah. Oh, tadi ya, jawapan petak Zidato ni memang sesuai untuk tahun 1 lagi. Tapi sebab yang tahun 3 ni, saya murid ni saya baru ajar. Maknanya darjah 1, darjah tahun 1, tahun 2, cikgu lain yang ajar. Jadi dia masih tak boleh kuasai. Jadi saya gunakan petak Zidato tu untuk mereka. Tapi yang kalau saya ajar murid tahun 1, dia dah memang terus boleh guna petak Zidato ni. Saya cipta sendiri. Cadangan saya ni ingin, saya mungkin nak gunakan apa? Kita gunakan komputer lah. Saya masukkan dalam komputer untuk murid pula gunakan komputer sendiri. Dia tekan, dia bergerak. Tangan tu yang bergerak. Jari tu yang bergerak. Tapi tengah cari aplikasi yang sesuai untuk penambahan tu. Sebab murid ni kadang-kadang dia bila kita berikan dia bahan yang biasa dilihat, dia rasa tak seronok. Jadi kalau kita create dia dalam bentuk yang lebih, yang digital punya, mungkin lebih seronok dia buat menyelesaikan soalan. Itu harapan saya lah, dalam usaha belum tercapai lagi.
Yang ini saya tengok dia melibatkan operasi tambah lah ya, yang mereka satu simple, dia tak ada dalam bentuk yang lebih kompleks lah, di mana ada tambah dan tolak, tambah dan sebagainya. So ada tak perancangan untuk meneroka?
Yang ini sebenarnya ada tambah dan tolak. Dia ada tambah dan tolak. Dia sekarang ni petak Zidato ni dia bukan masa dia bukan kita mengambil nombor macam 1200 tambah, bukan. Sekarang isunya apa yang saya tengok murid ialah dia tak boleh menambah. Kalau contoh 5 tambah 8 pun dia tak boleh. Sebab tak boleh, sebab jari dia tak cukup. Cikgu kalau suruh angkat dia 5 tambah 8, dia akan angkat 8. Dia akan kira semula 8. Di 5 dia angkat, dia mula dapat, dia kata jari dia tak cukup. Ah, cikgu, jari saya tak cukup, cikgu. Macam mana saya nak buat? Ada anak murid saya sampai menangis tau masa saya ajar tu. Dia sebab dia kata jari dia tak cukup. Lepas tu saya katalah, pinjam jari saya lah. Ah, kan? Tapi bila saya sediakan petak zitan tu ni, dia suka sebab dia tak perlu lagi nak fikir manalah jari dia. Manalah jari saya. Ah, macam ni dia kira. Dia kira. Okay. Saya tambahkan pula dengan workbook ni sebab saya nak tarik lagi dia punya apa minat dia, belajar dia. Sebab tadi kalau petak zitan tu dia, dia kena berkebergantung kan dengan petak zitan tu. Sekarang saya nak belajar dia mengingat. Tapi kita tak boleh paksa macam kita apa sebut. Masa kita, saya budak-budak dulu, cikgu matematik saya buat rotan untuk agar siku yang hafal, betul? Sekarang kita tak boleh. Jadi kita kena ada pendekatan baru. Pendekatan baru tu lah, ni lah dia, teknologi. Kita belajar, dan saya juga belajar untuk mengajar. Itu saja.
Ada soalan yang lain? Sebab petang ni kita hanya ada dua pembentangan saja, jadi kita ada masa yang lebih berbanding pada sesi pagi tadi. Pada sesi pagi tadi tu kita kena berhenti pukul 10 untuk minum pagi dan forum lah. So ada apa-apa soalan ataupun dah jelas dengan apa yang dibentangkan? Ya? Okey, saya dimaklumkan setiap sesi mempunyai
kod yang berlainan. Kod yang berlainan, jadi di kerjasama. Jadi kerjasama.
Jadi kerjasama peserta di bilik Zamrud ni dimohon untuk scan QR yang disediakanlah ya. Minum petang ada disediakan untuk semua peserta. Seperti pagi tadi, sesi apa untuk minum pagi tadi di ruang legar Dewan by Dewi, di tempat yang sama juga ya. Pukul 3.30 petang, ini pun dah 3.32. Dan sijil penyertaan bagi peserta walk-in saja boleh ambil daripada meja pendaftaran ya, di aras lobby. Untuk yang walk-in yang tidak menginap ya, boleh ambil apa sijil yang disediakan. Okay, sekali lagi kalau ada apa-apa pertanyaan, kalau tidak saya tutup. Okay, kalau tiada, saya ingin merakamkan setinggi-tinggi penghargaan, round of applause pada dua pembentang kita petang ini, iaitu Puan Zeti Erni daripada IPG Kampus Perlis ya, dengan tajuk pembentangan Digital Education Through Research in Digital Teaching and Learning, the purpose of using Google Classroom from the perspective of primary school students. Yang kedua ialah Puan Rosita binti Paiman dari SK Sumarusun Kampar Perak dengan tajuk kajian Pendekatan Latitubi Berasaskan Teknologi dan Petak Zitato Membantu Meningkatkan Penguasaan, menambah dua nombor dengan mengumpul semula bagi pelajar tahun 3 ya. Kedua-dua pembentangan telah dibuat dengan sangat baik dan kajian yang dilaksanakan pun sangat menarik untuk kita teliti dan ketahui ya, dengan lebih lanjut. Jadi tanpa melengahkan masa, saya jemput semua untuk minum petang. Saya akhiri dengan wabillahi taufiq wal hidayah. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Terima kasih semua.